lost.
Remember, if your children was beat the target score.
You have to pull the lines down.
Oh, no. You're
showing
the instructions.
Look,
damn,
it's
snowing.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Well, why are you not talking now?
Hi.
Hi, guys. Welcome back to our channel. Today, I have a special guest. You want to introduce yourself?
This is my first time on the channel?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Okay, this is my first time on the channel. I'm Syreena's husband, Brian.
Brian!
So today, we thought that we would do a video and call it Our Homeschool Dad.
So, I thought we could just have a slightly candid conversation about our homeschool dad. I wanted to incorporate him more on our channel because he is a major part of our homeschool, and I just wanted, you know, that's part of my vision. I want us to do more together, and I don't want to just be the teacher because I'm not just the teacher. You know, I'm not the only teacher because he's here and he teaches them a lot of wonderful stuff as well. So it is a snowy day today. So we've been in the house playing video games and
just hanging.
So I did film a couple of other videos and I thought this would be fun to do since he's here. So it's nice to have you.
It's good to be here. Thank you for inviting me on your homeschool channel.
I did jot down a few like questions to help us start the conversation. Mm-hmm. The first question is, what do you think about the educational path that we have chosen for our children?
Initially, I wasn't for it. Syreena came to me with this idea, I don't know, before we had kids. And I was like, absolutely not. I've never known anyone that was homeschooled coming up or since, even my adult life. I didn't know anyone was homeschooled, so I was against it. Then after she brought it up, I started meeting people that homeschooled their kids. And they just talked about why they did it, you know the how their kids had developed so forth since, and I became more open to it, and I'm happy we did it now. In hindsight, I'm happy we do it, and I'm excited about it.
And I brought it up after we had Cameron because I had no idea. Yeah, definitely. Okay. Yeah,
he was small though. He wasn't.
He was almost school age.
Okay.
Because I hadn't really thought about it. He was just going to school.
Yeah, I wasn't trying to hear that.
But actually what happened was, it was impressed upon me and I mentioned it to him and he was just like, that's strange. But, and I let it go because I kind of didn't know much about it either. So I just moved on in life. But then he started coming back to me with all of these people that he was meeting and articles he had come across and a bunch of different other stuff that brought it back up again. So I only really talked to him about it initially when it was first dropped into my heart, and then he was the one that brought it up over and over and over again until finally we just went for it.
Yeah. Shortly after she brought it up, I met a guy at our church and they had four kids and they had homeschooled all four. They had homeschooled their oldest all the way through, I think, high school. The two middle, I think they homeschooled them through around the middle school age, and they homeschooled the younger one, but he just, you know, we just started talking. I met him, just so happened, I met him around that time, and we started talking about that a lot. So he was a big influence, and I just started meeting all these people that homeschooled all of a sudden, so.
And the only person that I had come in contact with that homeschooled was, I was a photographer, right? I am a photographer, but I started photography right after I had Cameron, which is my oldest. And I started a second shooting for weddings. And there was a girl, a photographer in Maryland, that I ended up hooking up with to second shoot for a wedding that she had booked. And so I went down to meet her and second shoot with her, and through our conversation, during the wedding, I found out that she was homeschooled. And I think she was like one of maybe she was one of seven, one of, I know it was more than six, I think. She may have been one of seven mm-hmm. children, and I was just really impressed by her, just in general, her spirit, and she was young, like she was super young yeah. with this business, and I was just really, really impressed. Like, you know, sometimes you meet a person and you just know that they were raised really well. And, which is, this is a side note, but since then she has grown up and she has a family now, and she's still doing photography, but her mother ended up passing away and she wrote a book about her memories of her mother and her the lessons that she learned and her experiences with her mother. And it's called Meet Mama Bear. And so maybe I'll link that below because I've been wanting to get that and read that as well, because she made such a beautiful impact on me when I met her. And I just remember thinking, like, this child, like, she must have the best parents ever. So I did want to check that out, and maybe you guys might want to check that out too. But anyway, that was random. Also, I'm still in my PJs.
Put your PJs down.
Like, it's a snow day.
It's irrelevant.
It's a snow day. Okay, what is the best part about homeschool?
I would say for me is the bond that I see that the kids have with Syreena, being home and her being able to be with them all the time. The memories that you're able to capture being with your kids all the time. Well, you know, her being here and not having to be at work. Also, with them being young, is I think the biggest thing that I remember being in school is that you gain a lot of things. You're impressed by other kids, like peer pressure, where you just learn a lot of stuff from what other kids do at home. And I think at least for them being young at this age, we're able to explain things to them and bring and introduce things to them, versus them hearing something at school or from this person, picking up something from that person. So them being a young age, us able to set that kind of foundation, you know, with them.
And what else, what do you think is the best part as far as learning and education wise?
I don't know, they really seem to have a desire for learning. I don't remember having a desire for learning when I was going to school, whether at that age or older. So I would say they seem to really enjoy it, and the things that she does with them, whatever activities they're doing or whatever they're learning about, they seem to really enjoy it and look forward to it.
And that's such a blessing to hear. Like, I did show him some of these questions ahead of time, but some of them I didn't, and it's really nice to hear what they think, because, you know, as a homeschool mom, you do a lot, you know, the majority of the research, and you hold the majority of the vision, I would say. Well, in our house, I do. And so you're just constantly communicating that with your spouse and, you know, hoping and believing that you guys will be on the same page, and we do really well with that. But you always, you know, wonder what their answers would be to certain things. So knowing that he notices that or sees that that is the case is really, like, it's just really sweet. It's really sweet. So what is the hardest part about being a homeschool family, homeschooling?
I would say the teamwork. I think we all, the calendar and the teamwork, I think we all have to be, you know, her and I really have to be, you know, on the same page. It takes a lot. From, you know, me coming home from working and then jumping in so she has the time to rest, and then not only rest but then to do school prep and make sure she has everything. It's just a very very time consuming. So I think that's probably the hardest part, is keeping that calendar and keeping that flow going, you know, working together.
I would agree with that, because even though I think that that's a challenge for parents who, you know, kids who go to school and parents that work outside, both parents that work outside the home, they have this same issue, but in just a different way. Mm-hmm. I think for us, it was more of a process to develop that teamwork, because if I had a job outside of the home, would have to say is, hey, I have to be at work at this time, so you have to take the kids, and then I have to pick them up and all that other stuff. But when you homeschool, it's like, there's this assumption that you're home all day, so you're able to do everything. Like, you're responsible for everything. And so making it important enough to say, hey, I know you had a rough day and you're just getting home, but I need you to also pick this up and do this so that I can do that too. That was like a change and an adjustment. That's a hard one. Getting to that point where you take homeschooling as a whole seriously, so as serious as you would if the kids were in school or if you were at a job. And so,
for me?
No, the mother. You know, because if I say, oh, I have a team meeting that I have to be to, you know, when you homeschool, it's like you're creating all of the things and getting to the point where you take them seriously as well as your spouse takes them seriously. Mm-hmm. And that's been a process. So we've been homeschooling for a few years now, mm-hmm. and we're just now getting to a really organic, natural place where he actually considers this like a legitimate, you know, a legitimate like job. He considers it. I mean, it's more than a job, but gives it that much value and more. And so, another little cute thing that I noticed the other day was I had talked to him while he was out at work, and he mentioned something that I had done, and he said, oh, I was wondering, because I thought to myself, she couldn't be up working yet. Like, he calls it working, which, you know, you can call it working, you can call it not working, whatever. But just the process of homeschool planning or whatever else you do to prepare as a homeschool parent, it, like he said, it was working. And it was so natural, and it was, you know, but it took us a little bit to get there because it's different. And you have to create that value for yourself and your home between you and your spouse before anybody else will take you seriously. So it's nice to be past the year one where you're just kind of scrambling trying to figure it out.
Yeah.
And the year two, and now you're just into like a groove where like this is your thing. This is what you're doing. Anyway, so now the next question is, what is your biggest pet peeve about our homeschool life? And you can be honest.
Okay, so it's gonna sound really selfish. But the biggest pet peeve is that I'm never home by myself. If, like, say I get a day off or I come home early or whatever, they're always here. They're always here. I'm never, she actually went with my parents to my aunt's house last week. And I came home from work, and I was like by myself until maybe 7-8 o'clock, and that never happens. Like, I can count on one hand in the last year how many times that's happened. It's extremely rare, and it was awesome.
And I wanna do more of that, you know, create more of those opportunities in 2017, because it is difficult. You know, as a homeschool mom, there's so much going on, and we have a lot of other challenges, certain sacrifices. Thank you. We have certain sacrifices or challenges or whatever that arise. And so one in particular is that we've had car issues. So a lot of times we are just working off of one car. So that can be really challenging when you need to go around and do things. He normally ends up doing a lot more of the errands and the grocery shopping and things like that, because it's easier for him to get accomplished while he's out. And so sometimes you just have to create more of those opportunities. So his mom and dad were off, and they were going to see her sister, and I did want to go, but I did have a lot of things that I needed to get done here. Thank you so much, okay? So I did have a lot of things that I needed to get done here, but I made a choice because I knew that if we went, that he would have at least a few hours by himself when he got home. And I knew that that is precious, to be able to come home from work and just come home to an empty house that is quiet, that you can think. And so I want to do more of that in 2017, because you really have to create those opportunities. Otherwise, you will just not have them. So, yeah, that was a good one. She said, I'm the chef, you know that. Okay, so we'll try this again. What do you think about me as a homeschool mother / teacher?
I honestly think you're doing a phenomenal job. Syreena does not come from a household where her mom stayed home or whether she was homeschooled. So to do it to do this, to stay home and then homeschool and not have kind of a diagram or a playbook of what that looks like to kind of to look back on your childhood, I think she's done a phenomenal job.
Well, thank you. That was such an honest answer.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah. Points.
Points.
She's doing a great job.
Thank you, babe.
You're the best teacher.
Thank you, babe. How do you help as a homeschool father? How do you help? I can talk about this too, but.
I'm trying to continue to learn how to help her the way she needs me to help. You know, I think when we started off, I would try to help the way, you know, things I wanted to do, and it just wasn't working. So I'm really trying to learn how to help how she wants me to help. So usually my help looks like I'm just helping her day run more smoothly. So trying to be more consistent, making the kids lunch. I have flexible days where I go in a little bit later. If I'm going later and get the kids up, try to get them dressed and then get breakfast done. So that way if breakfast is done, lunch is done, then she can take care of dinner and not feel like she's going from meal to meal to meal. When I come home, I usually do clean up from dinner, do the kitchen, and then I'll do the kids' bath to kind of, you know, use that to spend some time with them too. And then usually try to do their Bible lesson throughout the week. So that's my help. You know, I've always, you know, errands and stuff when I'm already out. You know, I work in the field, so I'm usually already out going from place to place. So I'm just trying to learn how to help the way she would like to be helped. So it's difficult, but, you know.
Thank you.
We're all learning.
He is an exceptional help. Like, without him, it just wouldn't go the way that it goes. It just wouldn't. And I used to feel a lot of shame about it because when you stay home, there's this idea that the mom needs to do all these things because the husband is out working, and when he comes home, he should have a clean home and he should have food ready, and you should do all the lunch and you should do all the other stuff, you know. And that's just not the way it goes in our house. But in the beginning, it was difficult because you feel a sense of shame about not doing all of those things. And I just don't do all of those things. And, you know, sometimes when he does things, I get to rest. And sometimes when he does things, I get to work, I get to plan. And so it's a major help for me. And without him, I would not be able to do any of this. Like, I mean, I'm sure that there are homeschool mothers who have to do a lot more than what I do, but that's just not how we do things.
That's not how that works.
In our house, you know. So, and I've always hesitated to say things like that because people can be so judgmental about the way you do things in your home, but this is what works in our house. And without him, we would not be able to do the things that we're doing the way that we're doing them. So yeah, he is a tremendous help, and without him we could not do the things that we do the way that we do them.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And then the last one is, how would you like to do more in homeschool?
Field trips, I guess field trips would be one, I guess, and more of the day-to-day is, I try to do a lot with them with, you know, just Bible devotions. So more, she has a curriculum for that, being more regimented in what we're going over as far as Bible lessons. So last year we did a segment on, you know, faith, what's faith? Then we did a segment
on stewardship.
Yeah. We spent a lot of time on stewardship, you know, the parable of the talents, and then just explaining to them what stewardship looks like, what with your toys, what's your clothes, how to, you know, pick up your clothes and things like that. So that was a recurring thing. But being more regular with kind of a lesson plan for that, kind of what I want to be going over with them as far as like their devotions.
Yeah, and he probably won't say this, but he does an amazing job as far as the education part of homeschool is concerned. He writes vocabulary words that he wants them to cover on the board. He does their Bible lessons with them and does an amazing job just really talking through it with them and talking about different characters, you know, character lessons and things like that. He does a great job. What I did want to do for 2017 is start I'm gonna like create like a homework time where the kids can sit down and tell them all that they did for the day, and I think that'll help him feel a little bit more involved in our actual lessons. He gets caught up on the things that we're doing from a lot of the videos that we do.
Yeah.
So when I'm creating videos, I would like to think that I am serving him in creating videos. I really love to do it, but I really do believe that it is me serving him as a part of our family, because he forgets a lot of things. And so having memories to be able to go back through, he really enjoys. So it really helps me whenever I do, because I know I've seen people make comments about how do you have time to do all you're supposed to be doing well and then make videos. But I do think that, you know, in the word it says that your gift will make room for you. And I think that for me, making videos and taking pictures and things like that, they are healing for me, and they are a way that I can serve and a way that I can give. And in particular, it's to him. You know, I like him to have photographs of what they're doing or videos of what they're doing, things that he can look back on, because he spends, you know, all this time away from the home at work. And when he comes home, I never want him to feel like he's missing out on things. So I think it's fun to have something that he may not watch them, you know, every single time that I post something, but he always has something that he can go back to and look at. And so I like to be able to do that for him. What else? I was gonna say something else. Oh, so just to have that homework time that they can sit down and just share with them what they learned today, so he can find little spots that he can jump in and contribute, you know, because he has a lot of knowledge to be able to share with them. And I want him to feel just as close with them and just as a part of their educational journey as I do. Well, I think that was the last bit, the last question. Did you have anything else to add?
I did, and I'm glad I finally got an invitation to be on the channel. Just happy to be here.
I want him to be in more videos, and especially like the travel adventure type videos that we have coming soon, right?
Yeah. Coming soon.
You can visit our blog at syreenabblog.com/homeschool, our Instagram at syreenab, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.